He is highly regarded in social development circles around the world. Hailing from a family of top political leaders in the Philippines, 35-year-old Bam Aquino is inspired by the heroism of an uncle he has never met.
My uncle died for the country. I mean, what larger sacrifice is there? All of the possible sacrifices would probably pale in comparison to that.
Any Filipino of any generation would know the Aquino family, considered the most prominent political clan in the Philippines.
The history of public service actually began with my great-grandfather, Servilliano. He was actually one of the youngest generals in the Philippines. One of his children was Benigno, who was a Speaker of the House. And his son, of course, is the most famous one. My uncle and my dad's older brother is Ninoy, who, of course, in the Philippines is known to be a national hero, who was assassinated in 1983. Now, their son, Benigno III, or Noynoy, is the current president of the Philippines. Who is Bam Aquino? Well, what you see is what you get.
In 2007, Bam Aquino and his friends came to this town 3 hours away from the capital city of Manila. They came to establish Happinoy, a social enterprise that helps poor women get access to microfinance loans. It also trains them to become more business savvy. Edith Miranda never expected to cross paths with Bam Aquino and vividly remembers meeting him for the first time.
Parang sa katulad po namin na isang ordinaryong tao lamang, napakahirap abutin ng mga taong nasa ganong kakalalagay ng pamumuhay. Pero nung nandun na siya, talagang kuyang-kuya o kapatid, kaibigan na pwede mo siyang malapitan na hindi ka mag-aalang ang magsalita sa kanya.
Combination of happy and Pinoy. Yeah. Pinoy is slang for Filipino. So when you say happy Pinoy, Happinoy, it's like happy Filipinos.
My background. In the international arena, Bam Aquino also stands out. And not just because of his illustrious family name. When he participated in UN Women's Project INSPIRE in 2011, a global competition for young changemakers, the organizers saw a charismatic and compassionate leader in him.
When he walks into a room and when you talk to him, you know that this guy has, you know, not just the strength of a vision, but he has the personality too. Because you almost need the force of will to push through passion, you know, it cannot just happen overnight.
Sustained empowerment is best done through sustained enterprise. We've been able to see this change in the mothers, and we wish to continue this. For us, Happinoy is our contribution to the Philippines, but with your help and with the support of everyone here, maybe it can be a Filipino contribution to the world. Thank you very much. Magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat. Maraming salamat. There really wasn't anyone who said that you know, you have to be in politics, you have to be in government, you have to work with the poor, be in social enterprise. But it says that's your context. Growing up, that's your context. That's what you remember. That's who you're inspired by.
Then I phoned Cory.
One of Bam's inspirations in life is his uncle, Senator Ninoy Aquino. In 2009, Bam played the role of the late senator in a docudrama commemorating Ninoy's martyrdom.
I've always said that Mr. Marcos is the original terrorist.
Entitled The Last Journey of Ninoy, the film narrates the hero's struggles to liberate the Philippines from the rule of fear under President Marcos. When martial law was declared, Senator Ninoy became Marcos' first political detainee and was imprisoned for 7 years and 7 months. He was sent into exile in the United States after suffering a severe heart attack.
My next stopover was Malaysia.
The docudrama also chronicles the last 8 days of Ninoy's life as he traveled through 6 countries on a fake passport to return home after 3 years.
This is only good for the body, but in the head, there's nothing else we can do. So,
The director said, you don't have to act because you look like him. What was really nice was that my dad, the younger brother of Ninoy, was the voiceover of Ninoy. So it was a father and son paying homage to the uncle and the brother. No? No dry eyes in the hall every time it ends, even me, even if I've watched it 40 times. No?
If the Filipino people have lost their voice and would not say no to a tyrant, what can one man do? I have no army, I have no following, I have no money. I only have my indomitable spirit.
Despite threats to his life, Ninoy Aquino decided to return to the Philippines. He planned to plead with the ailing President Marcos to step down in the hopes of diverting a civil war after the dictator's death. But within seconds of touching ground, Ninoy was shot in the head.
I remember asking my mom, what's happening? What I knew dictadura at that time meant, you know, the current structures, the current systems had to be changed because Filipinos were unhappy. Innocent people get shot when they come home from the U.S. No? People were being put in jail because they didn't like what the president at that time was doing.
The death of Senator Ninoy ignited a renewed spirit of patriotism amongst Filipinos. And 6-year-old Bam decided to do his part for the country.
Now, can you imagine a 6-year-old saying ibagsak ang diktadura, which is bring down the dictatorship, no? But I did that, no?
Years on, Filipinos still search for the truth on who ordered the murder of Ninoy Aquino. The fate of his uncle has taught Bam about the beauty of self-sacrifice, something he's reminded of often at the family museum.
This is one of my favorite parts in the museum because it shows different shots of Uncle Ninoy when he was under trial by a military tribunal. No? Literally at this point, he didn't know if he was going to be dragged out of the courthouse and shot right there and then. So it was a very difficult time for him, for the family. I look at the pictures and you see a person who is just pouring himself out and just, leaving his fate to God. So this is actually the most, shocking or intense part of the museum, where you actually see the clothes that he died in. When he was shot, my grandmother actually made the decision not to fix his face. The quotation from her is that, "Let the people see what they did to my son." And that basically started people starting to come out and showing their anger and showing their displeasure with what was happening during that time. For a number of years, it was in the Guinness Book of World Records as the largest funeral march in history. The significance wasn't really the number of people that came out, but the fact that they did come out, join their fallen hero, go to his final resting place. No? Where was I? I was actually in here, in this small coaster. You saw the injustice that happened. And soon you would find that it's not just your uncle, it's so many other people, thousands of people. And you would see how, I think we don't give enough credit to children, no? And to the youth. No? I think if they see something wrong, they know sometimes even better than adults. No? And when you see something like that, you immediately know that things have to change. No? There were a lot of invitations for family members to go out and speak in different parts of the Philippines. And it just so happened that my dad was the non-politico, no? And it's a good thing he had a precocious, chubby little 6-year-old who wasn't afraid to speak in front of crowds. Now, maybe a little too naive to know the difficulties of that. According to my parents, I volunteered for it. Although I it's very difficult for me not to imagine myself not volunteering for it. No, no. Can you imagine a six-year-old saying "ibagsak ang diktadura," which is bring down the dictatorship? No, but I did that.
For 3 years, little Bam took part in about 200 rallies across the Philippines. He also campaigned for his aunt, Cory Aquino, Ninoy's widow, in the 1986 presidential snap elections. When President Marcos declared his victory at the polls, some 2 million Filipinos gathered at Manila's main highway to protest against the dictator. 3 days after, Marcos fled the Philippines. The world hailed it as the People Power Revolution, the first bloodless revolution in contemporary times.
To a certain extent, there is a certain magic in my mind, in my heart, about remembering those times. That experience of being part of something larger, I think, is really what stuck with me. No, and that's a very unique experience, no? To be part of something larger than yourself.
But some of today's Filipino youth are skeptical about the triumph of the People Power Revolution and Ninoy's sacrifice for his nation, like 25-year-old Carl Satinitigan.
So what I remember very vividly, our social studies teacher painting a picture of just pure helplessness in terms of as a country, even after such a powerful revolution. And we would graduate from high school not looking at it as a bright spot in Philippine history.
So, Carl changed his mind after meeting Bam Aquino during the 2010 Philippine presidential elections. Carl was a volunteer for a movement pushing for clean and fair elections, while Bam was campaigning for his cousin, Senator Benigno Aquino. Their groups met to plan an information drive for voter registration.
As a youth leader, we engage a lot of political families, and my experience before that was that it was always just instructions or a long sermon about what they went through. But this time it was different, and it was very results-oriented and very open to just new ideas. So I thought of school.
Over the years, Carl has witnessed Bam's unusual predicament thanks to his family name.
They tend to just, you know, burden out to unburden it on him, and it can be hard. For one, he admits that, you know, he's not he cannot answer these problems, and he cannot even have an access to whoever could answer to these problems all the time. So it could be, I think that's one struggle that he goes through. People expect very high things from someone with an Aquino family name.
Be that as it may, Carl believes Bam more than lives up to the Aquino legacy.
There are 1 million independent entrepreneurs also who don't talk to each other, who don't work with each other, who don't combine their purchasing power. They act separately from each other. And to a certain extent, this is probably the problem of the Filipino. No? We don't work together enough.
Up next, Bam's call for unity and empowerment. A year after winning UN Women's Project Inspire, Bam was invited to be a judge in the 2012 competition. The finalists, aged 35 and below, are hoping to win the $25,000 grant and be given an expert's view on their initiatives.
When the women start to earn more, are there cases where the husbands start to resent them? And is part of your program also making sure that the husbands and the women are able to help each other out through this process where they're earning more?
I think young people are in the best position to be at the forefront of change. No? I think young people have that idealism. The question is, can you convert that idealism into something that's real? And social entrepreneurs, I think, are able to do that. No? From the idealism stage, you're able to make it into a business plan or a business model, and you're able to implement it.
So it wasn't a startup fund for us.
The night before, Bam gave the finalists a much-needed pep talk.
So I'm warning all of you, if you win, you get stressed out.
night before, I was timing myself.
Jokes aside, BAM advised them to stay humble and leverage on this experience to achieve their mission faster and better.
Maybe a year or two, in our case, 4 years. So the award was good financially because we need the money, and but it was better in terms of opening doors. Because the UN women's group is still, I mean, you know, it's like Michael Jordan saying you can play basketball, right? You know?
BAM and his Hapinoy co-founders built their enterprise from scratch, and UN Women's Project Inspire was their first ever accolade.
I won't be ashamed to say we were beside ourselves with joy. After that, things just started to follow. We were awarded by the World Economic Forum, so internationally first before local awards. But it didn't happen overnight. No, it happened very slowly. It happened through a lot of hard work, heartache, financial cost.
You can have a strong business case. You can have the best intention, but I think you've got to have passion. BAM and his team obviously showed that. It came through and it was genuine. Going back to the business model, the scalability, the fact that everything was carefully thought through, every step along the way, it was always in consultation with the women. The women were what was the final goal, and it was everything was done with them in mind. You can't go wrong with a project like that.
Through Hapinoy, Edith has learned how to make her small family-run convenience store more profitable. Hapinoy taught her how to do a proper inventory system and manage her cash flow better.
Dati, ang aming pera ay sama-sama. Kumbaga, hindi namin pinagbubukod-bukod. Lahat ng gastos sa aming pamumuhay, doon lahat yung kinukuha sa pagninegosyo. Nung maturuan kami, na kung paano magnegosyo, yun, pinagbubukod-bukod ko yung dapat hindi doon kukuhanin yung lahat ng gastos sa bahay. Malaking tulong yun, ano, na nalaman ko na hindi pala lahat kailangan sa negosyo lahat kukuhanin.
Apart from teaching them basic business and life skills, Hapinoy store owners are also encouraged to gather and train other small stallholders in their village in order to form a cohesive network of vendors and distributors.
A lot of them come into the program thinking that because they were born poor, they will die poor. We try to change this, no? We try to say, Nay, mother, you can succeed. If you work hard, if you're open to learn, if you link up with other people who are trying to support you, if you run your store in a disciplined and smart way, you can succeed, and we can succeed together. Now, and that's the type of spirit that we're trying to do in Hapinoy.
In the Philippines, there are approximately 1 million stores like Edith's and 30 million small entrepreneurs. Hapinoy has helped close to 6,000 stores to date. It's a considerable feat for an innovative idea that got off the ground only with the founder's personal life savings and good name.
We're willing to risk our savings, our future, just to make this work. And if that meant, calling everyone that we knew to ask for support, in the beginning, that's actually really what we did. Every time that we had a difficulty, we would always say, well, the nanays that we work with have lead more difficult lives than us. So who are we to quit, no? Who are we to pack up? And every time that we had trouble, our board would basically ask, kumusta yung mga nanays, which is how are the mothers, no? Are they still doing okay? Are their businesses improving? Are they happy with the program? And every time we said yes, their businesses are doing well and they're happy with the program, then our board members would say, okay, then we should fight on and we should continue forth, no?
Few more years pass, the boy comes back. And as the boy is about to approach the tree, who is now a stump, the tree actually says, I have nothing left to give you. Wala na po akong pwedeng ibigay sa'yo. Ubus na ako.
These days, BAM spends more than half his time explaining the concept of social enterprise to various groups who wish to follow in Hapinoy's footsteps.
In Filipinos, in our case, in the Hapinoy Nanay, it's a very beautiful story. But it's not the story of a social entrepreneur. These days, when you talk about...
He fulfills these requests in gratis.
It just so happened that in pushing the public service agenda, you had to take on leadership roles. And as you take on leadership roles, then the public life comes with that. No? I think the public life, it's an offshoot of the public service. It shouldn't be the other way around. It should never be the other way around. No?
Since he was 18 years old, Bam has been approached to run for public office, but never saw a reason to step up. This time round, Bam decided to run for a senatorial seat in the 2013 midterm elections.
The work, good work that we've done has always been in pockets, has always been in specific communities. It's never been on a nationwide platform. You throw a pebble and it should hit a place where all of these activities and initiatives are available. And I said, okay, that can only happen probably on a national platform. And that became a more serious discussion about running for the Senate.
Whether his family name and his own achievements work in his favor or not, Bam says he will always remain true to the Aquino legacy and have the heart of a selfless child.
I would like to do my bit. We bring our people to a level where they're more comfortable, where they don't have to worry about what they have to eat or what their children have to eat. If they can reach their potential, if they can be happy, truly happy, if we can find a time when people can come together again for things which are greater than ourselves, if I can do my share to achieve that, then I will. And that's basically who I am. No?